Belinda presents this unabridged recording of
The Fabric of Sin, written by Phil Rickman, read by Emma Powell. Shapen of clay and kneaded with water, a bedrock of shame and a source of pollution, a cauldron of iniquity and a fabric of sin. What can I say that hath not been foreknown? Or what disclose that hath not been foretold? The Essenes, Poems of Initiation. Part 1. Do I believe in ghosts? I answer that I am prepared to consider evidence and accept it if it satisfies me. M.R. James, Introduction to His Complete Ghost Stories. Chapter 1. Third Hill. Although the countryside around the barn was open and level, three landmark hills were laid out along the horizon. Like ancient and venerated body parts, Merrily thought, the bones of the border. Holy relics on display in the sunset glow. Standing at the barn window with Adam Eastgate, she tracked them, right to left, from the southern end of the Black Mountains, the volcanic-looking Sugarloaf, and the ruined profile of the Skirrid, which legend said had cracked open when Jesus Christ died on the cross. Still somehow sacred, these hills. No towns crowded them. Nobody messed with them. At least not the way someone had with the third and lowest hill, the only one this side of the Welsh border, but still maybe a dozen miles away. The third hill had been stabbed under its summit, some kind of radio mast sticking out like a spear from the spine of a fallen warrior, a torn and bloody pennant of cloud flurrying horizontally from its shaft. Oh, Merrily said, realizing. Right. They say it's like another country up there. Garway. The light through the window was this deep, fruity pink. The sun dying somewhere behind the hill with its radio mast, its famously enigmatic church, and a farmhouse called the Master House that they were saying was haunted. Adam Eastgate had been aiming a forefinger like he wanted to stab the hill himself again and again. Sighing, he let his hand fall. We don't often make mistakes, Merrily. She'd never actually been to Garway Hill. Not before today, to this place either. A tidy cluster of converted farm buildings off a dead-end country lane, maybe 3 miles outside the city. Pieces of Herefordshire adding up to more than 12,000 acres were administered from here, on behalf of perhaps the most prestigious landlord in the country, and she hadn't even heard of it. All the stuff you ought to know about and didn't. Sometimes this county could be just a little too discreet. All a bit awkward. Merrily turned away from the window and the hills. Jane and I, my daughter, we keep planning to go over to Garway, check out the Knights Templar Church. Somehow never seem to find the time. Aye, we saw it with the man when he came to inspect the farm. Likes a quiet stroll when he can. And of course, it's always so quiet there. Nobody noticed us, even when... Adam Eastgate slipping her a cautious glance. Why are you smiling? You might not have seen a soul, but it'd be all over the hill before he was back in his Land Rover. Merrily looked down at the outline plans on the conference table. They were blurred. She rubbed her eyes. He inspects every property you take on, personally. Oh, he's not just a figurehead. The Brackeny accent digging in. Northumbria. In his dry, soldiery way, Adam Eastgate was affronted. Very protective of the man, the people working here. Does he know about this particular problem, then? Eastgate didn't reply, which could have meant yes or no, or not something you're supposed to ask. Okay, then. Merrily sat down in one of the high-backed chairs, red brocade. What, specifically, are we looking at?
Oh, hell. I can't tell you.
Perhaps I wasn't listening hard enough, you know. Or you find it embarrassing? Not a question of embarrassment, Merrily. I'm just not the man it happened to, if anything did. Always the get-out clause. How would you like me to play it, then? How would you normally play it? Well, dear God, how long was this going to take? To begin with, we usually try to find out if there's a backstory. Talk to local people. Village historian. There's always a village historian. Or maybe... She clocked his wince. That would be the wrong approach, would it? Depends if you want it on American TV before the week's out. Seriously? Merrily. Tight smile. I'm the land steward. Deal with builders, architects and tenants, right? Most of whom good as gold. But we know if we're forced to evict somebody who hasn't parted with the rent for 2 years. Next day's tabloids, we're half expecting Prince Put's family on the street. Oh, you see where we're going? Haunted prince calls in exorcist? Eastgate shuddered. Nice chap, Adam, the bishop had said. Knows what he wants and how to get it done. But raising this had taken the best part of half an hour and 3 false starts. This had been 2 nights ago, one of those receptions where the duchy was explaining its ambitious conservation plans to the great and the good of Hereford. The bishop and the archdeacon and their wives were having a drink afterwards with Adam Eastgate when the Garway investment had come up, and its complications. You could imagine the bishop nodding helpfully.
We do have a person, you know, looks after this kind of thing.
I mean, you'll have read the stuff. Same as I have, Eastgate said. He only has to venture an off-the-cuff opinion on whatever it is. Architecture, alternative medicine, GM foods. The benefits of talking to plants? See, there you go. That's exactly it. How many years ago was that? But do they ever forget? Well, no. This was the nation's last bit of official glitter. A face from commemorative investiture plaques. Royal wedding mugs on your grand's dresser. Merrily feeling slightly ashamed that, although she'd known it was most unlikely that the man would be here today, she was wearing her best coat. Her mother would have agonised, changing tops, changing shoes, inspecting her hair many times in the car mirror, just in case. Who is it safe to talk to, then? Who's actually living in the house?
Well, nobody.
I'm trying to explain. This came from the builder. Canny fella, normally. Or so I thought, till he's ringing us up. Adam, man, I think you're gonna have to find somebody else for this one. I'm gone. What? Eastgate walked to the darkening window, glanced out briefly, unseeing, turned and came back.
We're good employers, Merrily. In some ways, the best. Never short of tenders. And once they're allocated, we don't get jobs chucked back at us. Doesn't happen.
Merrily nodding. They'd be a fairly significant name on a builder's CV. But it worked both ways, Eastgate said. This builder had a rare feel for an old property. And the master house itself...
See, normally, we're not interested in anything less than about 200 acres. And this is what? 95. But it's a forgotten bit of old England. Right down there, on the very edge of Wales. Not much you find these days, completely unrestored. Hardly touched in over a century. We get to tease out the past. Plus, I'm thinking, craft workshops in the barns, the stables, the granary, a little working community, new economic life, and green, very green, wood burners, rainwater tanks, sheep's wool insulation.
Oh, he loves all that, doesn't he?
The man, it's his number one, and it influences us all naturally.
Eastgate shook his head.
I'm gone. Come on, Felix. What is this really about? You sick? Domestic problems? Adam, he says to us, maybe this is an old place that doesn't want to be restored. His words. Hostile, that was another. One of his team had a powerful feeling they were not wanted.
He pulled out of the whole project because one person thought he...
It's a she, Merrily.
Oh. The sun had gone, leaving a raspberry hue on the room. but you could still make out the shapes of the fields and the fuzz of hedgerows on the side of Garway Hill. I'm gonna to leave it in your hands, all right? Eastgate gathered up the plans into a black cardboard folder. You take these. They're only copies. See what he's putting in jeopardy. The bottom line being you'd like him back on the job ASAP. Only if he's normal. Look, if you want to ask a few questions locally, go ahead. We've nothing to hide. Bought in good faith, and what we have in mind is going to be good for the community. I'd just say exercise a bit more discretion than usual. Merrily nodded. My watchword, Adam. She had a headache. They walked into the forecourt, deeply shadowed now. Not quite six, and everyone seemed to have gone home. Maybe Adam Eastgate had timed their meeting for the tail end of the working day so he wouldn't have to explain any of this stuff to his staff. All the leaves were still on the trees and it was still warm. Too warm. A long flooded summer and the planet in the condemned cell. At least the nights were drawing in now. The tindery musk of autumn on the air as Eastgate walked with Merrily to the old Volvo. It had been nicked last summer, in the dark, obviously, and then swiftly abandoned, presumably after they'd heard the engine. So, just to get this right, what exactly will you do at the house, Merrily, to, depends what it is. You work on your own? I like to think not. She smiled wearily. He didn't get it. Okay, there are a few advisers I can call on, if necessary. Usually when there are people involved who might have particular problems. Psychological, psychiatric. When you're looking at an empty... that is, a house not lived in, as such. Oh, the way you shaped and trimmed your glossary of terms when addressing ingrained scepticism. Adam Eastgate cleared his throat. Only, I didn't think you'd be so. Small, female? I was gonna say... matter of fact about it. Meaning, like it's real. I don't do it all the time. There's also a parish, weddings, funerals, rows with the church wardens. I suppose medieval was the word I was groping for. I'm medieval. She looked up at him through the fast thickening air. You're working for an institution dating back, if I've got this right, to 1337. Duchy was created by Edward III to provide an income for his son, the Prince of Wales. The King's father having been the first to hold the title. Well, the first Englishman. And by that you mean, what exactly, Merrily? Well, they... flinching at the sharpness of Eastgate's glance. They had their own, didn't they? The Welsh, for a long time. And even after the princes of Wales had become English, there was Owen Glendower in the 15th century, still trying to get it back. But maybe mentioning this would not be very tactful. Not my subject, Welsh history. Thank God. Eastgate straightened up. Anyway, you keep us up to speed, I hope. Obviously, tell you what I can, without, you know, breaking any confidences that might arise. Not that this was likely. It didn't seem to be any more than what Hugh Owen would call a volatile or a delinquent. The wonky fuse box. The dripping tap. Deliverance light. Merrily unlocked the car. It's an empty house. If anything's happening, nobody has to live with it day to day. So we're looking at probably prayers, a room by room blessing. Or, if a particular and persistent personality is identified, maybe a Requiem Eucharist involving the people most closely involved, present and, where possible, past. 9 times out of 10, this is enough to restore a kind of calm. Adam, why is it called the Master House?
If anybody was able to explain that, Eastgate said, they didn't want to. Maybe the main house when there were subsidiary farms... or the local schoolmaster used to live there.
Hmm. She had a last look at the hill, where isolated white lights had appeared. Its big sisters, the Skirrid and the Sugarloaf, fading, uninhabited, into the dried blood sky. Adam Eastgate said,
Ever get scared yourself, Merrily? Me?
Merrily laughed. An unconvincing hollow sound in the stillness. An early owl picked it up, or seemed to, and flew with it as she got into the car. Chapter 2. Lament. Then he was back on the phone, Merrily told Lol in the pub. Soon as I got in, barely had time to put the kettle on. The Dutchie guy? No, the bishop. Must have rung several times already. I don't think I've ever known him this jumpy. I don't get it. She took a drink. Serious decadence. A house white spritzer in the Black Swan. Oak beams, low lights, with one's paramour. How long had it been before she'd felt able to do this comfortably? 6 months? A year? Seems stupid now.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.